Good afternoon. All right, so just a few updates to provide you today in reference to the weekend police officer involved shooting. Before I get to that, wanted to mention last week, I think it was, we posted an information sought for an animal cruelty case that we were investigating. Since we put that information out, two people have been identified and taken into custody. They're 15 years of age and 13 years of age. They're going to be remanded to juvenile court in reference to this incident. So we're still looking for the identity of others that were seen in that still pictures that we released, and some of the media, I think, released the video of that situation involving animal cruelty. So we're still looking at that incident as well. But two arrests have been made, two juveniles charged with animal cruelty, felony animal cruelty, and we're continuing to investigate that case, our animal abuse unit is. So as for the police-involved shooting, and shortly I'll get to some video footage that we have of that incident, which are it will include city watch footage and body-worn camera footage. And I have to first start by saying our city watch operators are certainly MVPs. Last week we saw a video that we released of a robbery in progress that they spotted and got our officers out there and to the scene quickly in reference to that. This is another incident that nothing had occurred outside of the fact that several men were arming themselves with guns. The officers were able to get there quickly before anything worse than that occurred and arrest a couple of the individuals and recover three handguns. During that incident, one of the suspects was shot. And again, I'll show you some of the body-worn camera video associated with that. That all unfolded overnight Saturday into Sunday morning at about 3:15. So it would be January 20th, 3:15 in the morning in the area of Park Avenue and Clay Avenue, or Clay Street. Again, the City Watch operator saw a group of males at a car and actually saw these males receiving handguns from the vehicle. Three of them armed themselves with guns, and a group of five of them started walking in the area. Where were they going? Friday into Saturday. My apologies. So Friday night into Saturday, January 20th. My apologies. Thank you for that. So that was January 20th at 3:15 in the morning, so early Saturday morning. So the group started walking along Park Avenue, and the operators called us out. Officers got there once again really quickly, and a foot pursuit began with pretty much all of the suspects that were armed. Two of the suspects discarded their weapons in the area, one in a dumpster, another one, I believe, in an alleyway. We were able to recover those. Another did not discard his weapon, and he was shot by a police officer one time in the lower, I believe, leg. So with that, I'm going to go ahead and play that video. And you're going to see, this is a pretty lengthy video. When I say lengthy, it's about 4 minutes long. It'll include the City Watch video and the body-worn camera footage. So just want to let you know before I get to that. All right, so this is just an aerial view of the vicinity. Mulberry and Park is the general area where it all began, and then Park and Clay is where it ultimately ended up, or vice versa. Actually, I think I have that backwards. Park and Clay is where it began. Mulberry and Park is where it ended. All right, so this is the video, and I will narrate some of this. You'll see the camera operator pan, this is on Park Avenue, and zoom in, and you'll see in regular speed the guns being handed over from the inside of the car. That's one incident right there taking place as he tucks his shirt down and gets himself together with his gun in his waistband. And then you'll see very quickly the guy in the blue hooded sweatshirt receive a gun and put that into his waistband area as well. And then the occupant of the vehicle on the passenger side gets out, and he is also armed with a gun. At this point, the driver of the vehicle is going to get in and leave. The group of five are going to walk in another direction, and we're going to pick it up with another citywide. So what's happening right now is the operator is observing this and relaying that information to our officers, and they're going to pick it up on another camera and relay the same information to our officers. This is just a slowed down version of the gun going into the waistband of one, and you'll see the same with the second suspect. So this part goes on for a bit, but what it illustrates is the City Watch operators keeping an eye on these young men as they walk down the street while we're waiting for officers to get into the area. The call is being simultaneously dispatched as the operators are following them down the street. We know at this point that three are armed with guns and they're walking down the street. Once they get to the corner, they're going to take a left and walk further down the street, and by the time they get towards the end of that block, you're going to see police officers start to arrive, and then we're going to transition into the body-worn camera footage. Apologize for the noise in my email up in the background. All right, so shortly you're going to see police cars arrive and you'll see a few of the individuals start to run. The two who didn't run were not armed with guns, so they obviously felt they had no need to run. But the three that did run were all armed with the guns. This is one police officer starting to arrive. They don't see him immediately, so he's trying to get up on him and get an advantage on him, but then again, they take off running. So this is just a frozen, his hand is right on the gun at that point. And there's the gun still within reach of him. All right, so just a still version. This is some of what you saw. The gun was still basically in his hand at this point. And that's what the officer's yelling at him to get away from the gun. And then he rolls over and there's the gun. And the officer gets it over there and gets away with it, gets it out of the way. So the suspect in that video was 20-year-old Brian Campbell. He's been charged with a handgun violation and a possession of a firearm by a minor. One of the things that we've talked about a lot, and people watch this video and don't necessarily understand, this is a misdemeanor offense. This is not considered a violent crime, but we saw what occurred, and we saw the capability. And I'm gonna show you the picture of the gun next. These, again, are two misdemeanor charges that he's facing right now. And as we've discussed on and on, our focus are violent individuals who wanna carry guns and harm people in the city of Baltimore. This crew of people likely weren't just going to target practice or range. I don't think there are any in that area they were going to. These group of people were likely up to something. And the City Watch operator and the officers likely saved someone from being a non-fatal shooting victim or a homicide victim that night. So, or even a robbery victim. So again, we don't know everything that was gonna transpire, But luckily, whatever it was interrupted by three guys who had three armed loaded handguns. This is the gun. I believe this is I don't know which caliber gun this one was, so I don't even want to say which caliber it is. But this has a laser on it. So it was loaded with a number of rounds, double-digit rounds, and ready to go. And fortunately enough, that wasn't fired at any innocent civilians or any police officers. The second individual who was arrested is 20-year-old Amari Hart. He's been charged with handgun on person, likely possession as a minor under the age of 21. And this is the gun that he was armed with. And he dropped his gun at a point during this foot pursuit. Officers were able to recover it and detain him. Again, his gun was loaded and ready to go. And here's the third gun that we recovered, and a trash can in the area was seen dumped by the third suspect. Investigators are making progress in the investigation into the identification of the remainder of the people that were involved in this incident, and we'll be following up with it right now. But once again, it's also important to note, as we look at this in the totality, of course there could be other charges coming on other individuals, but the mere possession of the handgun is a misdemeanor offense. And it was interrupted by astute city watch operators. And again, we just last week showed almost the same type of incident where an armed gunman walked into a store not far away from this and tried to rob the place. But luckily, we were able to see it, get there quickly, and get the suspects into custody. So that's what we have on that. Any questions in reference to this? Jessica?
Can you say what prompted the officer? There's just one officer that fired?
Mm-hmm.
Can you
explain
what made him?
So several officers were chasing this group of guys. And he had his gun out and ready to go. And as I explained, the two other individuals dropped their weapons because they knew that uniformed police officers were pursuing them. And that's important to note, and I know people that think that these guys are in the right and can carry their guns and have them out and all that is okay. It's not. They knew when those three marked police cars and three uniformed officers to start with got out and started chasing them, that police officers were chasing them. Two of them threw their guns down, and one was taken into custody immediately. The other chose not to discard his weapon, and there were officers coming from different directions, and he still had that gun out. When the officer was able to get around that corner, told him to drop it, and he fired a shot. But once again, the opportunity was aplenty for him to drop his weapon, which he chose not to do.
When you said fired a shot, it was toward an officer?
No, the suspect did not get any rounds off. The officer fired a shot.
Suspect was shot in the leg.
Yes, I believe it was the leg.
That was the first person you guys identified?
Yes. And I'll go back through this at the end.
Can you speak to just the help that City Watch kind of brought to all of this? I mean, obviously, those cameras helped, you guys mm-hmm. out initially. What's kind of their role now? Like, are they looking for any activity that's similar to this and just going to kind of monitor it and then alert you guys as things kind of progress? Or were you all notified, hey, we see guys that are getting guns, they're walking down the street here, you guys may need to monitor what they're doing?
Oh, yeah. I mean, they're on it. I mean, a lot of these City Watch operators are former investigators themselves, former police officers themselves. So they can recognize something isn't right. And again, some cases have a lot more detail than others. A guy walking in putting a gun right in the face of a clerk is quite obvious. this situation through your training, knowledge, and experience. You see this object being handed over and put into the waistband dip area. Again, trained observers, trained police officers know that that's indicative of a gun going into the waistband. So they are on it immediately and relay that information immediately and are the best eyes and ears as best possible to continue to watch them until officers can get there. That's what they did in this scenario once again. And fortunately, no one was injured in this scenario except for the person who had a gun.
And there's no indication as to what they were trying to do or where they were going or anything like that?
Again, I don't think it was a leisurely stroll. This wasn't just, you know, I need to arm myself to go walk my dog. These were, something was afoot. We don't know what, but luckily whatever it was disrupted. And again, none of them legally possessed these guns. The guns right now aren't coming back as stolen, but of course they're not properly registered or anything like that, but they're not coming back as stolen.
I know one of your missions of the police department is to get guns off the street and get the people who are supplying the guns off the street. The first shot there, the tag on the car was extremely legible. Are you following up on that to see where they came from and who?
Absolutely. That's part of our long-term investigative efforts in cases like this to backtrack where these guns could have come from. And, of course, the involvement of the individual who was driving the vehicle, who clearly someone was supplying guns to these individuals on the streets. Again, I don't have enough information to get into the particulars of what occurred that led them there in the car to meet with this group to arm them with the guns.
And similarly, you had no idea whether or not the gentleman who was driving the car wasn't going somewhere else to distribute more firearms, possibly. We have no idea.
Right, right. Right now, we don't know. Don't know the answer to that.
Was he arrested and was the car stolen?
No and no, but our investigation continues.
Has the officer that fired the shot, has he been placed on?
Routine administrative leave, 7-year veteran. All of the officers involved in this are assigned to the Central District midnight shift.
And are you identifying the officer that fired?
No, not yet. All right.
Anything else on the 7-Eleven?
No. We're still investigating that. So we're just asking for tips in that 7-Eleven case as well.
And both are still at large, still trying to find them.
Yes, sir. All right.
How many police involved shootings were there last year?
Ask me that cold. I don't know, but very few, comparatively speaking. I don't know the exact number. But it is on our website under the transparency page. You can look at each one of the cases. Yep. And did you have something else?
Yeah, I'm going to talk to you later.
Okay. All right. Good. All right. Thank you.